Welcome back to Living 808. He's been retired for 21 years from the sport of sumo. Konishiki finished at the second highest rank in the sport as Ozeki, but he stayed in the public eye with an active television and music career. Today, he joins us to catch us up on the latest and to tell us about his upcoming show. We welcome in Salivaa Atisanoi, also known as Konishiki. His wife, Chie, is just offset, and she's going to join us in just a minute. But thank you for being here with us. Appreciate it.
Thank you for Living 808.
Yeah, you're back for a little while, and we'll talk about that in just a second. But first, let's talk about sumo. Can you believe it's been over 2 decades?
21 years, man. I'm 55 this year, so it's been a while. But, you know, sumo has been good to not only to me, to many of Akebono Musashimaru were some of the names that came out of Hawaii that made it big. So proud that we as the local boys that kind of opened up the door to all the other foreigners. Well, thank you. Takamiyama, Jesse.
Yeah, Jesse kind of led the way, and then you guys laid the foundation for a lot of the local boys.
Yeah, it turned out to be where right now majority of the top wrestlers are foreigners now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you're retired from sumo, but man, you're busy. 16 years now as the star of a kid's show called Nihongo de Asobo.
It's like a Sesame Street show.
And you play Konichan.
I'm Konichan. If you ever find a chance to go on YouTube, you're going to find it. That's the picture you see.
My character. There he is. It's Konichan.
I remember a few years ago, I came to shoot here in Hawaii, and I was dressed like that the whole day. So I was in a truck going around, and people thought I was a pumpkin. So, no. I'm supposed to be the goddess child from the volcano. So that was my image.
Well, you love kids.
And, yeah, I love kids very much.
And you started the Kids Foundation after the earthquake.
96.
Tell me about that.
In 96, I started officially Konishiki Kids Foundation, and I've been taking kids up to Japan for like the first 10 years, about 55 of them with teachers and faculty. And then the earthquake, when the earthquake came, I had to just stop every day. That's 6 years, 7 years now. But ever after that, Japan is like every other year, every 3 years, there's a huge earthquake. So we went up there, we started feeding people. We have fed about 20, we have made hot meals, 25,000 hot meals.
Wow.
I deliver a 4-ton truck of just clothing, clothing and gifts for I do a Konichan Santa run.
Wow.
I become a Santa Claus the first week of December. That's all I do. My first week, I don't put any work, I straight up. In fact, people don't understand, northern Japan is like the top, north Japan all the way down, right below Hokkaido. It's always ripped apart by that earthquake. So what we did, we went out and delivered toys to 1,000 kids per prefecture every year for like 6 years. So I delivered over 20,000 gifts, I handed it off to the kids and stuff.
Thank you for all you do. You're just an amazing man and a local boy at heart that spreads the Aloha spirit out to Japan. But you're here because we wanted to catch up with you, but you're also here because on the 20th, you'll be playing at the Blue Note. Your show times are?
Are 6:30 and 9.
And maybe not a lot of people know that you have more than 10 albums out.
Yeah, people don't really know that I sing, but in Japan, majority of my time, my work is a lot of music. We do a lot of live music, so I do about 200 something shows a year, so.
Well, folks can find you on konishiki.net. They can also see you at the Blue Note on the 20th, singing away. And for now, take it away.
Ahivela. Ahivela. Maine iloko. Ika. Kila, kila,
He's